and supporting our students both at Timber Springs but also here at Timber Creek. And I'd like to especially thank you for your patience for earlier with everything. As you can see, we got it all working, so we're very thankful for that. I would like to recognize a few students at this moment. I know we're doing currently a stage change, but I would like to take a moment just to recognize a couple of students that actually this past week have performed for the Florida Orchestra Association solo ensemble. We had several students that actually participated, but there are three in particular I wanted to congratulate. We have John Metzger, who received an excellent rating, Ian Crow, and Maddie Mudley, who received superior ratings. So congratulations to all three of those students. Our January Timber Creek Art Student of the Month, our very own Miss Grace Lee. And very quickly, I would like to recognize and show our appreciation to a few individuals that have helped make tonight possible. I would like to thank our administration team. I know that we do have an administrator here tonight, also getting to serve as a parent as well. But Mr. Sharon, thank you very much. I know you're out there. We're very fortunate that we have just a really good supportive of performing arts administration team. So thank you to them. Whatever we could to make this happen. And poor Mr. Horn is on the phone watching his kids at home trying to help us while we're up here. And you don't get this kind of a program or a department where everyone can work and figure things out and make it happen and do the best thing for the students without having a faculty like that. I know he's not here. I know the rest of them all have their own obligations and everything, but we really do have an amazing faculty for performing arts, and I'm very thankful for them. We actually get to have her come in all the time to work with us, so we get a lot of feedback from her. But this particular evening, she is serving as a judge to critique us with feedback that we would receive going forward into our actual assessment. This is to better prepare us and help our students understand how the process works. And she's been working in the back tirelessly, but thank you to Ms. Caroline Anderson. I unfortunately decided that apparently this year was going to be the year of medical craziness. And the weekend before our first concert of the school year in the fall, apparently I had plans on being here and doing things, but someone else somewhere decided that was not the case, and I ended up in the ER with having to have an appendectomy. And that was real fun. It was a little bit scary for all of them because I just disappeared. But Ms. Anderson's the one that pulled everything together, and she came up without question. She worked with the students every day in the class periods, and then she voluntarily came in and decided, hey, these kids need an opportunity to have their concert. And without even batting an eye, said, sure, I will conduct it. So she had to learn all those scores, get all the kids ready, and do that in 2 days with me basically in the hospital. And I just, Ms. Anderson, we would not be here without you. Thank you so much. But she makes them better. All right, I would also like to thank our Timber Springs Middle School Orchestra Director. All of our students from Timber Springs, thank you so much for being being here, and thank you to Ms. Erin Davis. And now the biggest thanks for this particular event, and that is to our guest clinician. I cannot begin to tell you how exhausting these 3 days are. It's a lot. I know your students can tell you that, and with the exception of one student. The rest of them are only here for portions of it. One student is just special, is in multiple groups. But for our guest clinician and myself, we are here nonstop, and the amount of energy, the motivation, the knowledge, and the gift that he brings to our students is really top-notch. Very fortunate to have him. He actually is good friends with the orchestra director from my high school. And then on top of that, he currently, our guest clinician, works at my alma mater college. So it's a really kind of neat aspect to be able to bring him in and have him work with our kids. I think our students have gotten a lot out of him. I hope that they retained it all, because the amount of information he gave them was extensive, but it was also very, very worthy and valuable stuff that they needed. But we're very, very fortunate, and I would like to thank him. So for 3 tirelessly hardworking days, we're very appreciative of you. Thank you, Dr. Howard Sue.
Good evening, everybody. First of all, I would like to thank Ms. Conkling and the Timber Creek Orchestras for their warm hospitality. I've had an absolutely wonderful time, and it's my honor and pleasure to work with this excellent group. You really should know. I mean, because I think sometimes when you're in a place for a while, you may become a little, just kind of complacent with what you have. The program here, for the string program, would be the envy of just about every high school across this country. Where I am in South Georgia, there are no string programs. So we do not have that opportunity for our kids. So for example, the university has to step in with the program. So to come here and work with these students, I mean, this is the testament, to the excellence of these students, of Ms. Conkling, Timber Creek High School, and the administration in Orange County. So I think you really should recognize, what a special thing you have here. Just to go off a little more, because obviously this is something I feel very strongly about. When we have orchestra, what does it mean to have a string orchestra? Yes, we have these bright children with shiny and somewhat expensive instruments. And they dress very nicely, they clean up well, you should have seen them earlier, but they look great, and they play beautiful music. And, the fact that they get to play some of the greatest music ever written should be more than enough to have support of the orchestras the way, the Orange County has, and the administration of the school has supported this program. That should be more than enough. But then I really thought, and I've heard this said before, and I want everybody to think about this. What are we asking these children to do? We are asking them to learn a skill, refine this skill and practice it on their own, then bring it to a group and have this group project, do a group presentation. So you're, just like, you think about math, you learn like a theorem, but then can you really apply it? That's when you've learned it. They are learning to apply these skills in real time. And then, best of all, they have to do it. They have to show their presentation in public. And this group project also entails all the other skills that they have to learn for the real world, no matter what. Are we making them all professional musicians? No. But are we asking them leadership? Yes. Are we asking them to learn about verbal and non-communication? Absolutely. Are we asking them to be able to work with others? Yes. How many of you, in your workplace, have thought, why doesn't this person know how to work with other people? Or why doesn't this person know how to read somebody else? As far as, they say one thing, but you look at them and you think, I know that person means something else. Where do you learn those skills? When I speak about it this way, wouldn't you think any parent would be rushing to sign their children up for this kind of course. So the question is not, is orchestra worth supporting? It's more, why aren't more parents putting their children in these programs? So just so you know, you have something very special here, and it's been an honor to work with these excellent students. Thank you very much.
Stacey A. Conkling, and guest conducted by Dr. Howard Hsu, and the school's principal is Kelly Paduano. They will be performing Cacarole Suite by Warlock, Serenade Strings, Movements 2 and 3 by Elgar, Concerto in F Minor by Vivaldi, and With Fire by Mitchell, and please make sure not to clap in between any movements. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me in welcoming Howard Hsu and the Symphony Orchestra for the performance at the 2020 Pre-Music Performance Festival. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.